Okay, so fresh into the shower here, and I said, why not do a reaction? We got McAlmont and Butler, or McAlmont and Butler, either way, with Yes, this is the full version, the album version of The Thing. And these guys have been in my Save the Watch later for a while now, and I'm finally coming to them. And of course, Butler was with Suede, and McAlmont was with Thieves, and then they both kind of left those bands and then came together to create this song. And yeah, so let's get into it, talk about it after, let's go. My goodness.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so, my God. McAlmont and Butler, yes. I'm kind of just flabbergasted. I mean, I had to take a pause there. with McAlmont here, his voice, just sky-high vocals. I mean, my God, soaring voice. And it's almost like, you know, obviously it's a beautiful, luxurious, just big voice. And it's almost like two people singing or something. This sounds more... sounds like more than just one guy singing. I mean, and I do see a comment here on Wikipedia, on YouTube, where it kind of says, I think it says somebody said before that when McAlmont opens his voice, it's almost like a cathedral falls out. And that's very true, because again, it's just such a big voice. And with the string arrangements on this, with the guitars sounding so nice too, and just luxurious and just so big. And again, this is, as is put here actually on Wikipedia, they really do utilize the wall of sound technique, which I think was started by Phil Spector. And again, that really does fit because when I was listening to this, when it really started off, I had a feeling of like the 60s, like some 60s vibes to the song. And again, kind of that classic, I guess, classic feel to a song, whatever, even though this came out in 1995. And again, there's a fusion, I would say, of, I know Suede, I don't think they like being called Britpop, but that's what some people call them. And I know some people don't like the term Britpop, but either way, that kind of Britpop fusion of, you know, Britpop or just pop, whatever, soul, you know, some kind of Motown feelings. It's just like, I don't know, there's so much going on here, and there's so many fusions, and but it works so well together with these two, and just to create such a big sound and a big voice from McAlmont on this one too, like I said, and it's just glorious too, because it's like that whole, you know, finding your self-confidence again, finding, you know, being self-affirmed again, and just saying, you know, you're going to be all right, and you're ready to move on from the relationship or whatever, and it's just, it's beautiful. I mean, my God, and so I really enjoyed that. I mean, I can't say it enough. It's just, it's a great piece, and like I said, euphoric. This is a song you can listen to whenever you're going through a hard time, or whenever you've gotten over something, whatever kind of terrible event, and, or you don't even have to go through a bad event to listen to it. I mean, this is a song that you could probably put on repeat, I mean, and not get, you know, annoyed with it, my God. So anyway, it was just nuts. I mean, and again, I've been wanting to come to these guys for a while, and then finally here I am, and I mean, I've been missing out on the song for a while, good Lord. So anyway, I guess that's all, you know, everything I wanted to say at the top. Yeah, so let me go to these lyrics. You know, I never know if I'm done or not, but I think I'm done here before I go to lyrics. So with the lyrics, with the pre-chorus, and again, there's a lot of repetition here, but it's like, you know, that really fits the song. It kind of reminds me of, I think I've said before, but whenever a song repeats itself, it reminds me of the song Teenage Kicks from the Undertones, because they just repeat, you know, their verses again, because why not? It's just like, you know, why put anything else, you know? Let's just repeat what we already said, because the song is already good. Anyway, so you want to know me now, how I've been. So it's kind of like, you know, we come in, I don't know, there's a feeling of, so you want to know me now, huh? You know, I don't know, that kind of a feeling, where, you know, McAlmont kind of sounds a little bit reserved. You can't help someone recover after what you did. So, you know, I don't need your help to recover, goddamn. So tell me, am I looking better? Have you forgot? Whatever it is that you couldn't stand about me, about me, about me. Again, just so good. Just so self-assuring. My God. Let me go on to the chorus, because yes, I do feel better. Again, it's just, it's beautiful. You know, yes, I do feel better. It's just, oh, isn't that nice? yes, I do feel all right. I feel well enough to tell you what you can do with what you got to offer. So at that point too, I was thinking, you know, I can tell you where to shove it. But also, you know, he could maybe just be saying, I feel better to accept or reject any kind of offers from anybody. I don't know. That comes to mind too. And then the pre-chorus again. So you want to know me now, how I've been. You can't help someone recover after what you did. You know, that's repeated. And then we have the chorus again. And again, it just fits so well, because I didn't even really notice that they were repeating, I guess, because I was just so enthralled by his voice. And just the, again, the arrangements is just how that wall of sound. I mean, that's really what it is. It's so big. It's so powerful. And especially with the headphones on, I would say. And it's just glorious. Good Lord. Luxurious as all hell, too. And then the outro. On and on and on and on and on. And has no one said, stay away, stay away. I'm better, better, yes. And then we go on. I feel well enough to tell you what you can do with what you got. And then that's repeated many times at the end there. And again, not too many vocals for a too many lyrics for a 5-minute song. I thought there was more lyrics, but I guess I wasn't really paying attention. My goodness. And I kind of just want to finish off here with a quote, because I feel like this video is not very long for a 5-minute song. Anyway, I just feel like it's very simple to kind of get, and you can just go on about how much David sounds like an angel. But anyway, there's a quote here from Bernard Butler. I always say Bernard Weir, I guess. But anyway, it was the first piece of music I wrote after I left Sway. This is what he said from 2013 when he talked to NME. I wrote it as an instrumental. Everything was in place, but I didn't have the voice. And of course, who would get the voice? My God. Everything I'd done in the past 6 months had been really dark. I'd come out of a very sad situation and lost a lot of friends, so it was a very liberating song. And that's another big word there. It's a liberating song. I mean, my God. I met David at the Jazz Cafe in Camden and said, I've got this song. Do you want to try it out? He came back to me 2 days later and sang the first verse. He had no second verse. So I just said, sing the first one again. I want it to be like a great 60s piece of vinyl. So there it is there, talking about the 60s again. I did not see this quote before I talked about how it sounded like the 60s. Because that's just, as a fan of the 60s, you know, big fan of the Beach Boys, Beatles, CCR, whatever. Just, you know, I got 60s vibes. And I mean, goddamn, they really achieved their goal there to sound like a big piece from the 60s. So anyway, I just like how he was searching for a voice, and I mean, he really got a voice. My God, no one else could probably sing this like McAlmont. Just a soaring voice, and like I said, voice of an angel, talking about growth, talking about moving on, moving past, you know, your past, and it was just beautiful. And, you know, nothing dark. You know, how Butler said he wrote some dark things. This was not dark at all. I mean, my God, he went the complete, you know, other way on this one, and, you know, for good reason. What a great affirming song. So anyway, thanks for the request. A few people have mentioned McAlmont and Butler and finally got to them. My goodness. So anyway, and thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. Just the continuous support. I mean, into 2024 now. And yeah, so thanks for everything. I'll talk to you guys again soon.